create a pivot table and then the data changes, or you need to add new data to your pivot table. Let's go over ways that you can update the pivot table data source in Excel. So this pivot table is linked to this 2017 sales data. The data has changed since we created the pivot table, and so we need to update it with the new data. To do this, all we need to do is refresh the data, and there are a couple of ways you can do this. So whenever your active cell is anywhere in your pivot table, you'll have access to the pivot table tools menu. It has two tabs, the Analyze tab and the Design tab. In the Analyze tab, go to the Data section and you'll see a Refresh button. If you click that, it'll refresh the data in your pivot table as well as any other pivot tables in your entire workbook. If you need to only refresh the data for a single pivot table, make sure that's the one where your active cell is. Click this arrow, then click Refresh. As an alternate, you can refresh your active pivot table by right-clicking from within your pivot table and selecting Refresh. But what if you need to change the pivot table data source? Let's say that we need for this pivot table to instead pull data from this other data range. To change the pivot table data source, we can go back to the Analyze tab. In the Data section, this time we'll select Change Data Source. When you do this, you'll notice the current data range being selected. You can then delete what's in the Table Range field and select your new data range and click OK. And let's move this pivot table so it's next to the new data. If you have new data to add or you missed a row or column like I did here, you can use the same Change Data Source to fix it. What would be even better to help you avoid ever missing any rows of data is to have your data range formatted as an Excel table. If you need to convert your data into a table, make sure your active cell is within your data range, and you can either use the Ctrl T keyboard shortcut to convert it to a table, or you can come to the Home tab in the Style section and select Format as Tables. From here, select your preferred table style and click OK. So tables come with features that can make working with data easier. One of these is that when you group your data in a table, Excel realizes that you want all this information together. So notice here how a name has been assigned to our table. And if we select it, all the cells within the table are selected. This is important because it makes it so that as you add any new rows or columns of data to your table, your pivot table will automatically pick them up. All you need to do is refresh your pivot table to populate it with the new data. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.